Meghan Markle and Prince Harry end tour same way they started, holding hands. It's been great. That's a wrap on Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's epic royal tour down under. On Wednesday, local time, the royal couple completed the final, 76th, engagement of their 16-day tour, and they ended it the same way they started it, hand in hand. The newlyweds, who made the exciting announcement that they are expecting their first child at the start of their tour, touched down in Sydney on October 14 holding hands. And they hardly have let go of each other since. The couple also couldn't hide their baby joy throughout the tour. Harry offered a personal message when they arrived in New Zealand via helicopter, saying, "From myself, my wife and our little bump, we are so grateful to be here. We bring blessings from my grandmother the Queen and our family. We are so grateful for your hospitality and the work to look after this beautiful place." He referenced their new addition in his speech at the opening ceremony for the Invictus Games as well. "I have been so proud to be able to introduce my wife to you, and we have been so happy to be able to celebrate the personal joy of our newest addition with you all," he said. Meghan cradled her bump throughout the tour and excitedly accepted baby gifts from well-wishers. Their PDA-filled tour saw them showing their affection as they made their way through Australia, Fiji, Tonga, and New Zealand. And for their final tour stop, Harry and Meghan walked across a suspension bridge between 117-year-old ancient redwood trees. They left the forest holding hands as they made their way to their car. Harry turned to a group of reporters and summed up their successful tour in just a few choice words: "It's been great. Thanks, guys." Tomorrow, the couple will take off from New Zealand and head back to their home at Kensington Palace in London. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry meet two newborn Kiwis, achieve peak royal tour cuteness. Soon-to-be parents Prince Harry and Meghan Markle are practicing their baby skills. After attending a traditional Pali Rian luncheon to kick off the final day of their royal tour on Wednesday, local time, the pair headed to Rainbow Springs to learn more about the centre's Kiwi breeding initiative. Kiwis, which are New Zealand's national bird, have become increasingly endangered in recent years, as most chicks struggle to survive in the wild. Meghan and Harry met conservationists working to protect the species. In addition to seeing a newly hatched kiwi, the parents-to-be were given the chance to meet two young kiwi chicks born at Rainbow Springs just a few days ago named Taihai, which means sneeze of life or life force in Maori, and Koha, meaning gift. During the royal couple's outing in Melbourne, Australia, earlier in the tour, the pair hopped on one of the city's iconic trams for a short ride to South Melbourne Beach with student sustainability leaders. 12-year-old Charlie Wolf took the opportunity to grill Meghan and Harry on a name for the royal baby. Meghan kept mum, replying, "We've been given a long list of names from everyone. We're going to sit down and have a look at them." However, Harry was a bit more open when it came to their new addition. A video posted by the Instagram fan account Harry_Meghan_updates, shows a fan calling out to Harry that she hopes the baby is a girl, and Harry immediately responds, "So do I," as he continues to walk along the bike path. After wearing a long-sleeved navy dress by Stella McCartney, her wedding reception dress designer. For the Pauiri, Meghan changed into a deep blue sweater with a matching multicolored pleated skirt by Givenchy, her wedding dress designer. Meanwhile, Harry changed from a grey suit into khaki slacks and a black button-up. Meghan and Harry were also introduced to a yellow-bellied glider, a type of native possum, and lynx, a short-legged echidna. When they asked if lynx was drooling due to stress, they were told he was simply excited to see them. The royal couple started their whirlwind 16-day tour down under in Sydney, with a number of day trips to other areas of the country, and kicked off the 2018 Invictus Games before spending a few days in Fiji and Tonga. They returned to Sydney for the end of the Invictus Games before heading to New Zealand to wrap their tour.